Hello, this is Chef John from foodwishes.com with Pumpkin Zeppole. That's right, we're going to do a seasonal take on this very simple Italian donut. If you happen to be looking for something a little out of the ordinary for your upcoming Halloween party, these could work. Right, they may not be as scary as those bleeding eye truffles or those super spooky spider cupcakes, but nevertheless, I think they're very appropriate and will be very, very well received. But anyway, let's go ahead and get started with this ultra simple batter. And the first thing we want to do is put together our dry ingredients. So we'll start with some all-purpose flour, to which we're going to add some baking powder. Not baking soda, baking powder. And we also want a pinch of salt, as well as a generous spoon of cinnamon, and some freshly grated nutmeg. And you don't have to use fresh nutmeg. If you don't want it to taste quite as good, you can go ahead and dust off that old can in the pantry. And then all we're going to do is take a whisk and mix this enthusiastically for about a minute, and that's in lieu of sifting. Sifting is so 20th century. So we'll give that a proper whisking, and we will set that aside while we work on the wet ingredients, which we'll start with our secret ingredient, ricotta cheese. So I'm going to add some full-fat ricotta to a mixing bowl, and then to that we will add our pumpkin puree. And as always, I'm using pure canned pumpkin. That should be the only thing on the ingredient list. All right, we don't want to be using pumpkin pie filling here. And by the way, on the blog post, I'll explain why you never, ever want to use fresh pumpkin for this. So please check that out. And then we're also going to need some sugar, but not too much. This is not a super sweet donut. And then last but not least, we need 2 large eggs. And believe it or not, that's it. So at this point, we'll take a whisk and mix this thoroughly. And I may have mentioned this before, but one thing I always like to do when I'm mixing something is try to remember what I forgot. And as I was mixing this, I looked over and realized I never put the vanilla in. So I'm going to stop and add that. A nice little splash of real vanilla extract. So that's not a bad tip to pass along. Instead of just mindlessly stirring something, try not to forget to remember what you may have missed. And then once we have that mixed nice and smooth, we'll go ahead and mix our wet ingredients into our bowl of dry ingredients. Or should we do dry into wet? I never can remember. Although for this, I'm almost positive it doesn't matter. In fact, I know it doesn't matter. But anyway, we're going to take a spatula and mix our dry and wet ingredients together to form what's either a very, very thick batter or a very, very loose dough. And as soon as that's done, assuming your oil's hot, we can start making zeppole. And the way we're going to form these and get this batter into the oil is by using the old 2-spoon method, which simply means you scoop some with 1 spoon and then use the 2nd spoon to push it off into the oil. And I'm showing you that in the bowl here because I didn't know if I could film it over the top of the fryer. So you can practice that move a few times in the bowl, and then once you think you have it down, we can head over to the fryer, where we're going to fry these at 375 for about 2 minutes or so. So using the old 2-spoon method, I'm going to drop 6 in here, and not from too high up. You don't want to splash yourself. So get low, and what we'll do is we'll let those fry for about a minute, at which point we want to turn them over, which, by the way, they may do by themselves. But anyway, like I said, we'll cook them for a minute, we'll turn them over, and all that's going to take is a little nudge with your strainer. And we'll give the other side about a minute. For, like I said, a grand total of about 2 to 2.5 minutes. At which point, as usual, we will remove those to a rack to drain. And our pumpkin zeppole, also known as the world's easiest donuts, are done. And you are not going to believe how light these are. And how hot when they first come out of the fryer. So be careful. But these really are incredibly light. Not to mention really delicious. And that's serving this plain. But we're not going to serve it plain. I highly suggest you give these a little toss in some cinnamon sugar. And if you're not into cinnamon sugar, you could just use plain powdered sugar or maybe some kind of icing. That's up to you. You are the boss of making sure people go nuts for your donuts. But personally, I really do think that cinnamon sugar looks and tastes great. And would that have been easier in a larger bowl? Yeah, significantly easier. But eventually, I got them done. And that, my friends, is one nice looking pile of seasonal donuts. And look how gorgeous that color is. I mean, if you don't think that's a great color, you're not that good at colors, because that is beautiful. And in addition to their impossible lightness and gorgeous appearance, the taste is also excellent. They have a sort of subtle but still identifiable pumpkin flavor, which is obviously helped by the cinnamon and nutmeg. And what I think is very important, they're not too sweet. All right, there's nothing worse than a too sweet donut. And for me, these are just right. So I really do love how these come out. In fact, these delicious fritters are so fast and easy, I'm actually a little concerned you're going to make these too often. So please, I implore you, use this video responsibly. Okay? So I really do hope you give these a try. Head over to foodwishes.com for all the ingredient amounts and more info, as usual. And as always, enjoy.